Hello, Seahawks. I'm Jimmy Racinos.
And I'm Keenan Newman.
Alright, teacher cadet. Juniors with an overall 3.0 GPA and no discipline record may apply for teacher cadet for next school year. This is a college credit available for all juniors. You do not have to be an education major to participate. Please consider this course in your senior selections, for you will gain more than just college credit. For more information, contact Alyssa Cribb. Deadline will be May 12th.
Starbucks is hiring high school students of at least 17 years old of age. Please see Ms. Griggs in this guidance office if you're interested.
National Honor Society, community service hours are due May 19th to either Ms. Mara or Ms. Savion.
Cheerleading, there will be a parent meeting for all upcoming JV and varsity cheerleaders on May 6th at 5 p.m. in the gym at Myrtle Beach High School.
Cheerleading tryouts. JV and varsity cheerleading tryouts are going to be held May 19th through the 22nd, 2014, at 3:45 to 6 p.m. in the gym at the Myrtle Beach High School. All participants must have a current physical on file in order to try out. Application packets with recommendations and the physical form can be picked up in the guidance office.
Seniors, please bring all acceptance letters and scholarship awards to Ms. Griggs in guidance ASAP. This is information we must report after graduation. Thank you so much.
So much.
Goodbye,
Seahawks.
Hey guys, it's Dexter here, your junior class vice president, and I'm just talking to the freshmen, juniors, and sophomores about student council elections coming up this year. They're going to be a little bit different than we've done them in the past. We're actually doing next year's elections at the end of this year. So you're gonna have to get like teacher recommendation forms, and yeah, the campaign week is May 19th through the 23rd. So be looking out and be prepared.
Hello, I'm Mr. Glenn, and I teach broadcast and yearbook. You might not know this, but to take either of these two classes, there's a prerequisite. You have to talk to your guidance counselor, get an application packet, have it filled out, and return it to your guidance counselor. The deadline for this is May 14th. If you want to have an opportunity to be in either of these two classes, yearbook or broadcast journalism, you must fill out and return this application May 14th. Thank you.
This is HawkTalk Sports.
This is HawkTalk Sports. This is HawkTalk Sports.
This is HawkTalk Sports.
This is HawkTalk Sports.
This is HawkTalk Sports.
My name is Joseph Jumper, and this is Shark Week.
It's not what you're supposed to be saying.
Oh. It's HawkTalk Sports.
HawkTalk Sports.
Hey guys.
guys, I'm here with Cordell, and he qualified for the lower state track meet. So how do you think you'll do?
I think I'll do pretty good. I got a good chance at one of the states. You know, Coach was saying that all year. It'd be nice to have two championships in one year, so that'd be pretty cool.
How does it feel to qualify?
It feels great. I feel like I deserved it. We put in the work, so it's the results.
Awesome. Good job.
Hey guys, I'm here with Miranda. So Miranda, tell me, you have some questions for me, right?
I do, Jimmy. And I'm here with Jimmy, and I have some questions for him. So Jimmy, how does it feel to have qualified for lower states?
Actually, it feels pretty good. I actually didn't expect it. I was kind of more like, I'm going to go out there and I'm going to try my best. And I qualified three times, so, you know.
Three times.
I mean, yeah, not a big deal, but, you know, we're going to do great. You know, Ethan and the team, we got the 4x8 going in, so hopefully we play some, you know, we play top three.
Awesome. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
Hey, guys, I'm here with Ethan. So, Ethan, how does it feel to have qualified for lower states?
It feels amazing. It feels good because I can move on to the next race in lower states. And maybe after lower states, I can move on to the next race. And that race is states.
How do you think you'll do?
I think I will do good.
Good. You'll do good.
Let's go win.
Hey guys, I'm here with Chris. So how does it feel to have qualified for lower states?
Since it's only my second year throwing disc, it feels pretty awesome that I beat out everyone else that's been doing this all high school.
So, how do you think you'll do?
I have no idea what I'm going to be up against. Some of the best throwers in our area, but I'm just going to go out and give my best.
Good luck. Great. Go.
Hey guys, I'm here with Katie. So, how does it feel to have qualified for lower states in track?
It's really great. Honestly, it's really great that we've finally gotten enough people and everything to qualify for. And it's like just a self-accomplishment and everything. It's like, yes, I've finally done something. But it's awesome, really.
How do you think you'll do?
Honestly, I hope I'll do really well, but I've seen sometimes where girls are getting like 15 seconds,
yeah.
And I'm like, oh, that's a lot of competition.
Hi. Hi, I'm with Jennifer. So how do you feel about qualifying for lower states?
I feel good because I worked all season for it.
And how do you think you'll do?
I think I'll do pretty well. Just gotta work hard and do my best at it.
That's awesome. Well, good luck with that.
So everybody loves music, right?
Right.
And everybody has their favorite artist in the music industry, right? So we have all types of celebrities out. We have
Drake,
yes. A lot of people love Drake. He's very sentimental. And also we have music industry people that are also into the acting with like Will Smith. Who else we got? We got Akon. He hasn't been able to do it. We got Bruno Mars.
Yeah, Bruno Mars.
Everybody loves Bruno Mars now, especially after that Super Bowl. Treasure, that is what you are. Yeah. So we decided to let y'all know that there are some lookalikes in our school.
A lot of
the people that we just named.
Yep, yep.
So check out what we found when we went around Myrtle Beach.
Is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, you're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air. I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I can say that this cab was rare, but I thought, man, forget it, yo, home's the Bel Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8 and I yelled to the cabbie, yo, home, smell you later. Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel Air.
Hey, I'm here with Coffee and Centra, so you guys were aware that y'all were like two guys on PJs.
Well, I've been told.
Are you a witness to the white person?
What? No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm positive.